Hey guys, Sock here from Sock eTech, and in today's video I'm going to share 25 plus tips and tricks for your iPhone 11 Pro Max or the iPhone 11 Pro. I want to make sure that you get acquainted with your phone right away and know how to use it as much as possible. So let's dive in and start discovering. Now the very first thing I want to talk about has to do with basic navigation. So if you're a first time user for an iPhone, you need to know all these things. So basically, if you're inside an application, any application, if you want to go back home, you simply swipe up and that's going to dump you right back on the home screen. And then if you are already in an application and you want to actually access other applications that you were using in the background, what you can do is you can pull up slowly, let go, and then you get this card view from where you can switch over to various different apps that you are running in the background. Now there's also another way to switch between apps. Now at the bottom you can see a black bar, so you can just switch over just like that. You just swipe over and it goes to the next application. You swipe over, it goes to the next application. And finally, if you want to kill any app that's running in the background, you just bring it up just like that. You bring the card view up and you swipe up to kill any application that you don't want to use. So those are some of the basics of navigation. Now the next thing I want to talk about has to do with your control center. So on the top right, if you pull down, it gives you access to your control center. Now if you pull down from the center of the device, it's going to pull down your actual notifications. But if you do want to access your control center, you want to go right from here. Now with the control center, there are some updates to the iPhones with iOS 13. Now first and foremost, if you press and hold on any one of these squares or toggles, it's going to expand to give you even more options, all right? So the same goes with the brightness slider. It's going to expand. You can now change the brightness from here, which is a really nice design. And you have a bunch of toggles at the bottom that you can press to change settings in relation to the display. You can press the volume toggle here, and then you get the slider here. You can increase and decrease the volume. That's great as well. You can even press and hold on this option right here. That's going to give you an expansion. And then even press and hold on these options to get even further information, okay? So it shows you what Wi-Fi you're connected to, and if you click on this button, it will take you into the actual Wi-Fi settings. That's great, okay? So again, pull this down, press and hold, and then press and hold individually on these options to expand even further, alrighty? And then finally, what we have here is we have things like the flashlight. You press and hold, it's gonna expand that. You can turn on the flashlight and even increase its intensity. As you can see, it's turned on at the back, all right? So I can decrease the intensity or turn it off right from here. And anytime you expand something, if you press outside of that actual toggle, it's gonna go back, all right? So in a little bit, I'm gonna show you how to customize the control panel even further. For now, let's move on and talk about a couple other important things. One of the newest features that we have on these phones via iOS 13 is the new dark mode. So if I were to launch any application, music application, for example, or if I were to launch the calendar application, these are Apple installed system apps. As you can see, we have a bright white background. With the dark mode, all this can be turned into dark backgrounds, even the actual phone application. So what you want to do is you want to go to the settings, all right? And then you want to go to the main settings. Then you scroll down, go to display and brightness. On the top, you get a quick toggle that allows you to switch between light and dark. So if I go like this, boom, everything turns into a beautiful dark mode that's easy on the eyes. And also because this is an OLED display, it also saves you battery life, unlike the regular iPhone 11, which is an LCD display. So with this one, you're also saving some battery. Now, when I go back out, even the wallpaper has changed its character to a darker mode. I'm gonna talk about it in a second, but if I go to the phone, boom, dark mode, boom, dark mode, all right? So all these system apps have turned into a darker mode. Even if I go to the news application, it's gonna give you a dark mode, which makes it easy to read these things at nighttime, okay? So if you go to the settings, you can switch between light and dark, no problem. Now you can also switch between these modes by pressing and holding on this button and just clicking on dark mode right over here. So that'll give you the dark mode as well, as you can see, or you go right inside, boom, and it's right back in business. Now let me quickly talk about that, the wallpaper that I was just mentioning. So if you go to the wallpapers, If you go to choose a new wallpaper, and if you tap on stills, you do get a bunch of new wallpapers, these four guys here. Now I have this one enabled. You can have any one of these guys enabled. If you set this one, for example, let me set this real quick, set for home screen. Now when I go back home, you are gonna see the regular paper that we just set, as you can see. Now when I toggle on the dark mode, if I press and hold, click on dark mode, that wallpaper is also going to change character. Now that's part of all these four wallpapers that have a small icon at the bottom right, as you can see, that circular icon. So let me go back to this one right over here for the sake of this video. Set, go back out. We've got the dark version right now because of the dark mode, but I'm gonna turn that off. By the way, you can also turn it off using this toggle here. So that's the dark mode on and off toggle, which is quicker than pressing this. All right, so you can go like this, dark mode on or off. Now real quick, if you don't have this right here, you can easily enable it, okay? All you do is go to the settings, all right? And then you go into the regular settings, then you scroll down, go to control center right here, and then you click on customize controls. And as you can see, I have the dark mode on the top. You can have this anywhere that you want if you desire. So you can grab this, put it all the way down, just like that. Now, when I pull this down, dark mode is gonna be right here. I can toggle on and off. Just so you know, that's how you customize the control center as well. All right, now the next thing I wanna talk about is how to access Siri. Now you can also say, hey Siri, if you so desire, and it's gonna pop right up. But if you don't want to say that, what you can do is you can actually press and hold the power button, and that's going to activate Hey Siri as well. So that's the power button that activates Hey Siri. So if you want to turn off the phone, what you have to do is press and hold volume down and power at the same time, all right? Just like that, at the same time, that's going to bring this power to slide off option if you want to turn off your phone. Now there's another way to turn off your phone that I'm going to talk about towards the end of the video. That's a cooler feature, but we'll come back to that in a little bit. So that's one way to turn off your phone. So let me just log into my phone real quick. The other thing is, if you want to take a screenshot on your phone, what you do this time is press volume up and power at the same time and let go. Don't press and hold, just let go. So let me show you that. There we go. So we just took a screenshot that goes down over here. You tap on it. Once you tap on it, you can customize it as you please, all right? So you can resize it, you can grab a pen, you can draw on it if you wanna customize it a little bit. You even have a ruler here that you can use in any way that you want to draw precise lines on it, as you can see, okay? So that's fantastic. When you're done, you click on done, delete it, save it, or save it to photos. It's up to you. So you save it to photos, and that's how you take a screenshot. Not only can you take a screenshot of your phone, obviously, you can also actually record your screen. So what you can do is you can pull this down and you want to look for this record button. Press and hold, it expands and it says screen recording. Now, if you don't have the screen recorder here, again, all you want to do is you want to go to settings, all right? Under control center, you go to control center, you go to customize. And you want to make sure this screen recording option that might be down here somewhere, you click that green plus symbol and it goes here so you can use it. And like I said, you can put this anywhere that you want, all right? So when I go back over here, if I press and hold, I get these two options. I can click on start recording and it's going to do a countdown, as you can see. And once that happens, the screen is now being recorded, as you can see. Whatever I'm doing here is being recorded and it's going to be saved into my photos application. All right, so if I want to stop the recording, I press the button on the top here and it says stop. And then screen recording has been saved into photos. When I go into my photos, it's going to be the latest photo that I have here. Now, as you can see, that's what I was recording and talking at the same time. All right, so again, just to be very clear, when you press and hold on this, when you choose photos, this is just a location you can save them. So if I go to Messenger and I click start broadcast, it's gonna broadcast to my Messenger and I can send it to somebody else. But if I choose this, it's gonna save the recording into actual photos application. They need to change that camera icon to the actual photos icon. Now, one more thing that's very important is, in fact, your notifications. Most of the time, we are getting notifications. So you want to make sure you manage them properly. So when I pull this down, I get all these notifications. What I can do here is I can swipe on a given notification and I can clear that notification, all right? I can swipe over, I can also view that notification, all right? And then I can swipe over and I can manage that notification. When I click on manage for that particular application, I can even turn off the actual notifications by tapping the turn off button, or I can go to the settings and actually make it even more customizable based on my needs for that particular app that I'm actually interacting with right here. So when I pull this down, anytime you swipe over anything, for example, let me just find a different notification. So here's one from news. So if I tap on this, they're grouped normally. If you tap on the expands, you can individually kill a notification by doing like this. Or if you tap on show less and get a full group from a single app, you can swipe over and manage them all together. Clear that up. And if I swipe this over and if I click on manage, again, you can have these options: deliver quietly or turn off notifications or manage notifications for the Facebook page right here with more detail. All right. The next thing is very important. It has to do with security. Let me go into settings. All right. Go to the main settings. And then scroll down and go into Face ID, dump in your password. And when you're here, scroll down, and here's the most important part. So it says here, allow access when locked. So even when your phone is locked, through the lock screen, people can access all these functions, which could be a security problem for you personally, or maybe a business setting. So when I turn off the phone, and if I turn it on by tapping over here or whatever, I can pull this control center down and I can make modifications, for example, to my home using the home control app. So this is actually allowed even the phone is locked. So let's go inside and fix that. So what you want to do is you want to go back into Face ID. You want to scroll down and disable all these options. All right. Disable them all. You can keep it on based on what they are by reading what they are. But now if I go to the lock screen, if I try to pull down the control center, it's inaccessible, all right? So nobody can do anything with my phone while it is locked. So that's the Face ID and passcode. One more important thing here, of course, if you scroll down a little bit, you wanna make sure this option right here is enabled, require attention for Face ID. So when you're trying to unlock your phone with your face, the phone is going to make sure you're actually looking at the phone with your eyes wide open. Because if you were sleeping in your bed, somebody can grab this otherwise and use your face to unlock the phone as you're sleeping. But if you have this enabled, the phone is gonna know that you're not awake, your eyes are closed, and it's not gonna unlock the phone. So that's a fantastic option. And finally, you wanna go up here and you wanna make sure all these options are enabled so you can use your Face ID to unlock your phone, make purchases in iTunes, do Apple Pay verification in stores, and even autofill your passwords. By the way, if you tap on this one, this shows you all the other apps that are authorized to use Face ID. If you wanna deauthorize any one of these apps, if you're not comfortable, you can simply turn that off and that app is not gonna be able to use Face ID. You're gonna have to dump in your actual password, all right? So that's how you manage other apps from here. So that's Face ID. And the next thing I'm gonna talk about also has to do with security. It has to do with your Notes application. What you are able to do with Notes application is create secure notes that are locked with a password. As you can see, it says, this note is locked. If I try to click it, it's gonna ask me for a password, for a unique password to unlock that note. So let me show you how to create that. So if you tap on this one right here, let me just say secure note, okay? So you do that, and then you click on this share button, and from here you scroll down and you say lock note. You tap on that one, it's gonna ask me to put in my password. Let's just dump that in there. And now that note is, in fact, it says lock added, but I have to press the lock button to actually lock the note. If I want to view the note, I have to click it, put in the password, boom, and it's going to unlock the note. Now, when you do this for the first time, it's going to ask you to pick a unique password just for your notes. If you ever want to change that password in the future, you go to the settings, the main screen, scroll down, go to notes, boom, all right? And then go into password right here, and you can change the password for those notes, or you can even use your Face ID to unlock a locked note. That's absolutely fantastic, all right? So one more thing with the notes. If I grab any note right over here, let's see, this is a very important note. Again, you can tap on this button, you can pin this note. So let me just pin that by clicking this. Now that note has been pinned to the top, as you can see. And of course, you can in fact pin multiple notes to the top, just so you know. So when I go back here, this is the pinned section for important notes that pop on the top. All right, let's move on to the next tactic. The next thing that's important is to know what's happening with your iPhone's storage. So if I go to the settings, again, main screen, you scroll down, you go to general, and you tap on iPhone storage, and that gives you a breakdown of how your space is being used. So as you can see, I'm using 36 gigabytes of my 64 gigabyte capacity, and I can always look over here and see what applications are taking most of the actual space. By the way, you can also see here, a breakdown is given to you, showing you apps are taking the most space, media just a little bit, and then you got other things over here. But if you want something, if you don't need something, for example, this game here, I've never played this game. So I click on delete application, boom, and now I have 2.74 gigabytes extra space available for music and other kind of media, okay? So that's why you wanna make sure that you properly manage your storage. The next thing I wanna talk about has to do with a special button you can activate on your phone to give you some extra functions. So let's do that right now. So let's go to settings, go to accessibility, and then let's go to touch, and then go to assistive touch, enable this little button. It's gonna be all over the place. When you tap on that button, it's gonna expand and gives you all kinds of cool options. You can pull down the control center right from here. You can tap on this, you can go home right from here. You can tap, you can put this anywhere you want, by the way. It'll just hang around the corner. You tap it, you can bring down your notifications if you want, and then you can tap it again. You can go to device and even lock the screen using a software key. That's fantastic. So that's the assistive touch functionality. One good thing with this assistive touch functionality is it's fully customizable. You can go here, you can remove icons and re-add them and then assign specific functions to it. I can do a 3D touch function or just a home function assigned to the button I just added. I can add more buttons. So click on that one, just double tap, click one more time, click on that. Let's just say lock screen, okay? Click done. Now that menu reflects my customization right here. You can always reset this to go back to what the phone comes with. And of course, when you're done with this whole thing, you just turn off assistive touch if you don't want it, and it's gone, all right? Now, a newer feature that we have on the iOS 13 with these iPhones is if you go to the photos, all right, and if you click edit on the top right, right over here, you're able to edit and modify photos with quite some detail with a new interface. So first you have the auto enhance, so you can enhance these photos as you please. You click on the option, activates the dial at the bottom, you just play with that. Or you can change the exposure, you can change the brilliance of that photo, it's all up to you. You can change the highlights, shadows, contrast, there's so many options. This is almost like a professional grade editing tool, and of course you can do things like this. So again, you click here, okay, and that activates a dial at the bottom, and you can do all kinds of weird things. It's all gonna be up to you, all right? When you're done, you just click done, and you get a brand new photo. Now, the same editing tools actually apply to a video. So if you have a video, you can actually edit that video with the same powerful tools. You can also add effects just like that to the actual video. And also change the, you can flip it around just like this, okay? Even with the videos, so that's great, all right? So make sure that you utilize this if you are a photo guy or a photo girl. All right, so that brings us to the end of this video. Make sure you subscribe to Saki Tech for more iPhone tips and tricks videos. There is much more to talk about In this video, I just want to give you guys some cool tips to get you started, get you acquainted with your phone, and learn some useful stuff on your iPhone 11 Pro Max or the iPhone 11 Pro. All right, so drop questions, comments, concerns down below. And for now, have a fantastic day, all right? All right, so if you found this video useful, make sure to subscribe to Saki Tech by clicking that button, and also click that bell icon on the side to make sure you get notified every time I upload a new video. And if you do use Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook, you can follow me at Saki Tech Online to get the latest updates as well. All right, have a fantastic day.